Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy teaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I render exposition of John 1.11 onward. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. Now he came among his own because Christ Jesus was to appear among the people of Judah tribe. But the people of Judah tribe, they received him not, because they were most stanic people among the people of the chosen. So they received him not, they became his enemy. They were more, remember that during the time of King David, the people of Judah tribe, they were very particular, they were very angelic people, and they were ideal people. So in the dark age, they become opposite. They apply their religious knowledge for making money out of that, for greed and other thing. So they become the best cheat in this dark age. So such people who are cheat and who are not clean hearted, they need a doctor to clean their hearts. So Christ Jesus, he is a spiritual doctor. So he came among his own. His own mean he came among the people who were most spiritually sick, the people of Judah tribe. And those people did not receive him. They were the people who hated Christ Jesus the most, who deceived him most. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. Now, the Christ Jesus, he was Son of God with capital S. So he was Christ. Christ stands for the Royal Priest of God, or we call it who is the hawker of his word. That means he was proclaiming the gospel of the royal kingdom of God. But as many as received him, as many as people who received his gospel in their heart, to them gave he power to become the sons of God. So those people who received the gospel in their heart, they became sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. So even those who are once born and they could not understand what royal priest stand for, but they did work like Peter, who was once born. He served, so he had the quality of speaking the truth and to serve people. So those people once born who believe in Christ Jesus and do render services to the people in his name, they also become sons of God. So when you become sons of God, you become like your Father. Our Father God is eternal, and so people who become sons of God, they also become eternal, and they don't face death, as Jesus showed in the case of Lazarus, who had become the Son of God, and even though he died and he was rose again to life, to tell people what eternal life is like. So people who you become sons of God by grace of God. So people who become sons of God, they have become eternal, and their birth and rebirth cycle is cut. Which were born not of blood, So those people who are twice born, they are not born of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. So unless God willeth, you cannot be son of God. So you cannot have the grace to become the sons of God. Remember Peter, of the 12 laborers, Peter was once born, and he was with Christ Jesus, but he could not understand gospel. For not understanding gospel, because he was once born, he was called a stone, a Peter. So a stone, when you put it in water, nothing soaks in. So was Simon, and nothing was soaking into his head when Christ Jesus was preaching gospel. So he was given the taste of the gospel when Christ Jesus asked his laborer, "What do you think I am?" Then everybody told, "You are like Elijah and this and that." But people said first, then Jesus asked them, "What do you think of me?" So everybody gave his opinion, and Peter said, "You are the Christ of the living God." So then Christ Jesus stressed that unless my Father gave you this thing, you can't have it. So people who understand gospel, they are by the grace of God, and they should take advantage of that one and preach gospel rather than to go for mammon. Because many are called, few are chosen. So many people are sensible enough, are twice born, but they get frightened of the other people and they choose to go for mammon rather than for God. That means they go for businesses where you cheat others and you use your common sense or intelligence in the wrong direction. And the Word was made flesh. Now the Word is Christ, and Christ is a title, and it was made flesh in the name of Jesus. So when you saw Jesus when you saw Christ Jesus in the street, it was Jesus you saw him, not the Christ. Christ is the light, and unless you are twice born, you would not understand the gospel of Christ. So the Christ is title, never born, never die. As the Word was with God and is not born or die, so is the Christ. It was Jesus, the name of his flesh, that was born and that died, and he dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth, full of grace and gospel truth. Gospel truth is called absolute truth. So whatsoever cometh out of the mouth of Christ Jesus was non-erring, and it was absolute truth. So they dwelt among us as Jesus, and we beheld his glory. So the apostles who preached this gospel and wrote this one, they observed his glory when they were working as a laborer with him, and they were trained to become a fully qualified workers, and that qualification was given through Eucharist of sacrifice, which is the baptism of Jesus in Holy Spirit. So I will